It's $8 billion. That's the initial cost that Paris budgeted for the 2024 Olympics. The French capital has spent around $4.5 billion on infrastructure, including $1.6 billion for its Olympic Village. S&P Global says if the final cost of the 2024 Olympics stay within the ballpark of $8 billion, then Paris will have hosted the cheapest summer games in decades. Apparently, boneless chicken wings are just a figment of the imagination in Ohio. The state Supreme Court on Thursday ruled that consumers cannot expect boneless chicken wings to actually be free of bones. It threw out the complaint of a restaurant customer who suffered serious medical complications from getting a bone stuck in his throat. The complainant sued the restaurant, Wings on Brookwood, claiming it failed to warn him that their boneless wings could contain bones. But in a 4-3 ruling, the state's high court said boneless wings only refers to a cooking style and that the complainant should have been on guard against bones since chickens naturally have them.
Japan urges vigilance against excessive foreign exchange rate fluctuations driven by speculation. During the G20 finance ministers and central bank governors meeting in Brazil, Tokyo's top currency diplomat Masato Kanda said attention is needed on risks of prolonged high interest rates in some countries, destabilizing financial markets. His comments follow recent wild swings in the Japanese yen. The currency rallied for a fourth straight session against the U.S. dollar on Thursday, recovering from 38-year lows earlier this month on suspected intervention by Japan early this month. Analysts had blamed wide U.S.-Japan interest rate differentials for the yen's weakness.
S&P Global urges faster infrastructure development in emerging Asian economies like the Philippines to unlock faster growth momentum. In a new report, it said the Asia-Pacific region could nearly double its economy to $11.4 trillion by the year 2033 if infrastructure projects are accelerated. The S&P report cited the ongoing infrastructure push of several Asian governments, including in the Philippines, India, Malaysia, and Vietnam. Here at home, the public works sector is one of the Marcos administration's priority investment areas. The NEDA board has so far approved 185 infrastructure flagship projects with a total value of 9.5 trillion pesos. The governor of the Philippine province of Bataan remains hopeful the oil spill from the sunken MV Terranova will be minimal. Governor Joy Garcia identified the owner of the ill-fated tanker as Shogun Shipping Incorporated. Garcia says his office is in contact with Shogun, along with disaster authorities and other government agencies.
Kahapon pa yan na-detect, but we are hopeful and we believe that it is not coming from the main tank. So okay. It might have come from the engine, the pipes, the sludge within the vessel. So right now, the inspection team, PCG, the salvage master are doing their assessment and we should get a clearer picture within the day to the extent of the oil spill and the possible actions that will be taken by the salvage master to secure the contents of the tanker.